Good morning, and welcome as we gather on this fourth Sunday of Easter for the service of morning prayer here at St. Luke's Church in Woodstock. And welcome to all of you, and welcome to those who will be watching from home a little bit later. I want to extend condolences to the family of Joan Margeson, who passed away recently. And so I ask you to remember the Margeson family in your prayers. And also, we extend happy birthday to those celebrating this week. Happy birthday to Lauren Saunders and Gary McBride, Lila Ryder, Audrey Thornton, and Ann Tate. And Ann tells me that her son James was born on her birthday, so he will be celebrating this week as well. And happy birthday to anyone else who may be celebrating a birthday. And I'd like to extend happy anniversary, a belated happy anniversary, to Larry and Naomi Sharp, who celebrated, I think, their 22nd anniversary yesterday. So happy anniversary to you, and to anyone else who may be celebrating an anniversary this week. We give God thanks for his gifts of life and love and family and all those wonderful blessings that we enjoy in this privileged life that we live here in Canada. So how do we do that? Well, let's do it twice. Let's sing happy birthday and then happy anniversary. So here we go, twice through. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, God loves you, happy birthday to you, happy anniversary to you, happy anniversary to you, happy anniversary, God loves you. Happy anniversary to you. And many more. And so we're going to join together in singing the hymn number 520, The Lord is My Shepherd. We'll sing verses 1 and 4, and you may sing if you are wearing a mask. Scripture says, I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my own, and my own know me. A call to prayer. It's printed in the bulletin. And so let us pray. Gracious God, thank you that you are over all, in all, and through all. We lift our world before you as we face this COVID-19 pandemic. We pray for those who are suffering its effects, the medical personnel who are caring for them, and those who are seeking a vaccine or cure. We pray for the success of the vaccines in Canada and in other parts of the world. We are grateful for the lives of people who have died and pray for their families and friends in their bereavement. We ask that you enable us to know your love for all and give us your peace, which passes all understanding. In the name of Christ, our Lord. Amen. We continue with the penitential rite on the bottom of page 45 and the top of page 46 in the Book of Alternative Services. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. Dear friends in Christ, as we prepare to worship Almighty God, let us with penitent and obedient hearts confess our sins, that we may obtain forgiveness by His infinite goodness and mercy. Let us pray together. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And for the response before and after the jubilate, we use response number 10, and that is also printed in your bulletin. Alleluia. The Lord is risen indeed. O come, let us worship. We join together in saying the Jubilate, which is on the bottom of page 49. Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age. Alleluia, the Lord is risen indeed. O come, let us worship. Please be seated for the proclamation of the word, and I invite Ruth to come for the scripture.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter and John before the council. The next day, their rulers, elders, and scribes assembled in Jerusalem with Annas the high priest, Caiaphas, John, and Alexander, and all who were of the high priestly family. When they had made the prisoners stand in their midst, they inquired, "By what power or by what name did you do this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, "Rulers of the people and elders, if we are questioned today because of a good deed done to someone who was sick, and are asked how this man has been healed, let it be known to all of you and to all the people of Israel, that this man is standing before you in good health by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. This Jesus is the stone that was rejected by you, the builders. It has become the cornerstone. There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among mortals by which we must be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm this morning is Psalm 23, found on page 731 of the Book of Alternative Services. Psalm 23. We shall read it responsively. The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not be in want.
He makes me lie down in green pastures
and leads me beside still waters.
He revives my soul
and guides me along right pathways for his name's sake.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil.
For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You spread a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me.
You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup is running over.
Surely your goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
We pray together. Glory to you, Jesus Christ, our Good Shepherd. In the waters of baptism, you give us new birth. At your table, you nourish us with heavenly food. And in your goodness and mercy, you guide us beyond the terrors of evil and death to your Father's home to dwell in eternal light. Glory to you forever. Amen. A reading from the first letter of John. Love one another. We know love by this, that he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for one another. How does God's love abide in anyone who has the world's goods and sees a brother or sister in need and yet refuses to help? Little children, let us love not in word or speech, but in truth and action. And by this we will know that we are from the truth and will reassure our hearts before him whenever our hearts condemn us. For God is greater than our hearts, and he knows everything. Beloved, if our hearts do not condemn us, we have boldness before God, and we receive from him whatever we ask, because we obey his commandments and do what pleases him. And this is his commandment, that we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another, just as he has commanded us. All who obey his commandments abide in him, and he abides in them. And by this we know that he abides in us, by the Spirit that he has given us. The word of the Lord.
I invite you to turn to our parish mission statement, which is printed in the bulletin on page 3. Let us say our mission statement together. We are a worshiping Anglican community nourished by liturgy, scripture, sacraments, prayer, and fellowship. We are guided by the Holy Spirit to care for God's creation so that all may know the peace of Christ and the power of his resurrection. I invite you, if you're able, to stand for the Holy Gospel. The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus, the Good Shepherd. Jesus said, I am the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because the hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason, the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father. The Gospel of Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. O God, help us to listen to your word with understanding, to receive it with faith, and to obey it with courage. For Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. The title of this message is, Are You Included in the Flock? I meant this morning to bring a sheep that I have hung on a wall in one of the bedrooms, and it's an actual sheepskin that I purchased many years ago when I visited New Zealand. And New Zealand is full of green hills covered with sheep, and so I bought this sheepskin that looks like a lamb, and it's hanging on my bedroom wall. It's actually a pajama bag that you could poke your pajamas in, unzip and poke your pajamas in. So I meant to bring it as a visual, but I'm sure that we can all visualize in our minds what a sheep looks like. And we do not have to drive very far outside Woodstock to find a quiet, peaceful, pastoral setting. You know, fields of potatoes or corn or pasture with cows or horses and the beautiful St. John River Valley. Chapter 10 of John's Gospel is a pastoral setting. Anyone who may have visited Israel will know that much of the country is rural. The hills are all around you. The flocks are all around you. It is a shepherding land, a pastoral scene. A great deal of the Bible is written against this agricultural background, well, similar to the landscape we find here in Carleton County in many ways. It is interesting that many of the leaders of the people of God served in that apprenticeship for the task of shepherding sheep. Moses was one. David was another. And in looking after sheep, they learned how to look after people. Note that shepherding in the Middle East, unlike here in the Western world, is a dangerous life. The shepherd must go out by himself looking for a bit of grass. Now, unlike here, a great portion of the country of Israel is barren desert. And so to find grass is no easy task, but it is there. And the shepherd must find still water. We're reminded of the Psalm 23. The shepherd must find still water, for sheep cannot drink running or troubled water, because the water is too close to its nose, and the sheep will get water up its nose. And so the shepherd looks for still water and green pasture. And when he finds it, he must go and lead the sheep to it. And a sheep can walk only so far, so the shepherd must know when to let it lie down. Is any of that sounding familiar? You're thinking of Psalm 23? This is a setting for chapter 10 of John's Gospel. And to further understand chapter 10, it is helpful to know what happened in chapters 8 and 9 preceding it. Chapter 8 is about a black sheep, a woman caught in adultery. And chapter 9 is about a blind sheep, a man born blind. And the people who should have looked after those sheep were bad shepherds. In chapter 8, there was a woman caught in adultery, and they wanted to stone her to death. She was a black sheep in the fold or in the flock of Israel. And the shepherds of Israel should have dealt with her better than they did. And in chapter 9, there was a man born blind from birth, an outcast because he could not earn a living. He was a blind sheep. And they threw him out of the fold because he could not see. And that is bad shepherding. It is against the backdrop of the bad shepherds in chapter 8 and 9 that Jesus says in chapter 10, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd. By implication, the others are bad shepherds. They did not help the sheep who were in trouble. Jesus says, I am the good shepherd, and I want to tell you what a good shepherd is. And that is the background, the setting. And chapter 10 begins with Jesus telling a parable about a sheep and a shepherd and the relationship between the two. And the disciples do not understand it. And so Jesus explains its meaning. Jesus draws a contrast between life and death. And think about this: life for the sheep and death for the shepherd. The story is an allegory, a picture of the people around him. And he makes a statement that everyone has tried to be a Christ before him is a thief and a robber and not a shepherd. Israel suffered greatly because there were high hopes of a Messiah, and yet there were many false messiahs. Just like today, there are people who exploit the hopes and dreams of a multitude of ordinary folks. None of them is a shepherd. Plenty will say, "Oh, I will lead you out into freedom. I will lead you into pasture. I will give you what you are asking." They are thieves and robbers. They are after position and status. Jesus says, "Those who came before him were thieves and robbers. They did not get their authority through me," he says. "I am the door, and the true shepherd always comes through me. And if a man does not come to you through Jesus Christ, pay no attention to him. He is dangerous. He is a thief and a robber. He is after something from you." Does that sound at all familiar and like a little advice that we should be listening to today? Jesus says, "I'm not only the door for the shepherd, I am the door for the sheep. Sheep start outside my fold and then can come in only through me. There is no other way to heaven except through Jesus. Jesus is the door. He is the way." We recall elsewhere he said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." And there is no other way to salvation except through Jesus. And he says, "I am the door. The sheep will come in through me and be saved." But notice that the sheep are not only to come in, but to go out again. "The sheep shall go in and out and find pasture." And so your pasture you will find out there in the world. If you really want to feed and live, you do not just come into the church through Christ. You go out into the world through Christ. And perhaps we do not feel as safe out there in the world, especially during this pandemic. But let us remember that Jesus is with us. That's his promise. We are never alone. When we are out there in the world, we may have lost the security of the structure of the church or of the structure of our home, but we still have the security of our relationship with the Good Shepherd. We can be thrust out safely into the world because we have the Good Shepherd going with us, provided we stay close to him and follow him and not wander off on our own. Provided we keep within the reach of his rod and staff. Provided we stay behind him and do not rush ahead of him. And then we are absolutely safe out there in the world. Even though there is danger in the world, Jesus wants us out there. Why? Because he wants us to live. The thief comes to steal and kill and destroy. Jesus says, "I have come that you might have life and have it abundantly." We will not have a full life. Think about this. We will not have a full life if we stay within the church all the time. Church is a good place to come, isn't it? But for a full life, we need to be out there in the world with Jesus. That's why we have the dismissal at the end. Go into the world to love and serve the Lord. A life that is rich and full and free is a life lived with Jesus. coming in and going out through Jesus. How far will the shepherd go in order to look after his sheep? It is not uncommon in the Middle East for a shepherd to die looking after his sheep. They often fight off wolves and other wild beasts. Sometimes they die in the fight. So how many of us would like to be a shepherd? In the Old Testament, David fought with a lion and a bear while he was shepherding. And that is how he developed his skill with a sling that was so useful later with human enemies. Jesus, the good shepherd, is willing to die. And that is a strong statement. Jesus is good because he is willing to go to the length of death in looking after his sheep. There are many shepherds not willing to go to that length. And the reason is simple. You are only prepared to go to that length if the sheep are yours, if they belong to you. If you are only doing the job for what you get out of it, for your wages, there comes a point beyond which you will not go in terms of sacrifice. A hired hand, a hired servant, will stop at a certain point because he is more concerned with his own life than with the sheep. But the good shepherd says, I will go down as far down the road of sacrifice as the needs of my sheep demand. No line will be drawn. Whatever is required by the sheep, I will give it, to the point of giving his own life. And then Jesus talks about knowing the sheep and caring for them. A good shepherd knows the sheep and cares for them. Good sheep also know the shepherd. He says, I know my sheep and they know me. See, knowledge is a two-way relationship, isn't it? We can never have full knowledge if it is only one person knowing a lot about the other and not vice versa. It needs to be mutual. A shepherd has a duty to know his sheep, but sheep have a duty to know their shepherd. Jesus, in thinking about his sheep, thinks about all of them, not just a few of them, all of them. And in talking to the sheep in the house of Israel, he says, you are not the only sheep I am going to die for. I have other sheep. I look beyond this fold, and I have other sheep. I'm going to look after them too. And I'm going to join them to you. And my friends, this is a clear reference to you and me. I am a Gentile. I'm not a Jew. We are all Gentiles, meaning that we are not Jews. Thank God that Jesus had other sheep to bring, and we are included. And here is a glorious truth. My future and your future are bound up with the Jews, because there's going to be one flock and one shepherd. We will be part of the flock with the one shepherd, their shepherd. For Jesus was born a Jew, and he's still a Jew. And I thank God that Gentiles are brought into the fold. Aren't you thankful for that? We are included. And notice that we cannot do the job of bringing all the flock together. That is not our job. That is the job of the shepherd. It is a shepherd who draws the sheep to himself. Jesus says he is willing to lay down his life. No one imposes it on him. He does it entirely himself. He says, I make this decision. I choose to die. When we talk about Jesus being put to death, But that is really not correct. If you read through the Gospels, you will count that there were five attempts during Jesus' life to kill him. But none of them succeeded because Jesus did not let them. And he would never have been crucified unless he allowed it. Think about this. What use is a dead shepherd to the flock? None. Once he has died for the sheep, that is the end of that flock. It must be given to other shepherds. But in the case of Jesus, once the shepherd laid down his life for the sheep, it was necessary for God to give life back to the shepherd. It was necessary for him to be willing to take his life up again. And so Jesus says, I am the good shepherd. I lay down my life of my own accord, my own free will. I have the right to lay it down, and I have the right to take it up. And so, my friends, we do not have a dead shepherd. We have a shepherd who has died and is alive forevermore. And we have a shepherd who will go to the absolute limit and will then come back to look after us. Jesus says, I lay down my life and I take it up again. And for this reason, the Father loves me. God loves every shepherd who is willing to sacrifice for the sheep, who knows them and who cares for them. In all of this, Jesus is saying, I want you to put your trust in me. If you put your trust in others to be your savior, they will disappoint you. Have you ever been disappointed? There are in the world thieves, wolves, and hired servants with their varying qualities, whether they kill the sheep or run away. They are of no use to the sheep. We must be on our guard against them. Jesus is saying, I am the good shepherd. Look to me. The good shepherd knows. The good shepherd cares. The good shepherd dies and rises again and is ascended into heaven, and he will return. Jesus came to give us his flock abundant life on earth, and he will return to lead us to green pasture and still water and eternal life in his kingdom. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Thank you, Jesus, our good shepherd, for including us in your flock. How grateful we are that you care for us and lead us through the challenges of this life. Thank you for giving us this abundant life. Help us to faithfully follow you out there in the world where we can look for opportunities to lead others to you. In your holy name we pray. Amen. I invite you to turn to the words of the Apostles' Creed found on page 52, and let us stand as we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Today's intercessions are based on Litany 15, found on page 122 in the Book of Alternative Services. In joy and hope, let us pray to the source of all life, saying, "Hear us, Lord of glory." Heavenly Father, on this fourth Sunday of Easter, we give thanks for Jesus, the Good Shepherd, and pray for all who shepherd your flock, especially those in our Anglican cycle of prayer, for our church family and every congregation, that our risen Savior may fill us with the joy of his holy and life-giving resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for missionaries throughout the world who face opposition and challenges that we cannot imagine, that isolated and persecuted churches may find fresh strength in the Easter gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
Merciful God, give us strength as we cope with the COVID-19 pandemic and reach out with compassion to our neighbors, that you may grant us humility to be subject to one another in Christian love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
We give you thanks for this privileged life you have given us, and we pray for the compassion to provide for those who lack food, work, or shelter. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
Each day, the fears of war and violence escalate around the world. We long for the day when, by your power, wars and famine may cease through all the earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
As we give thanks for the gift of health, we pray for all who suffer from COVID-19 and other afflictions, especially those on our prayer list and others known to us. We remember the soul of Joan Margerson, and we pray for her family, that God may reveal the light of his presence to the sick, the weak, and the dying, that they may be comforted and strengthened. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
Sovereign God of the universe, we look to you for wisdom and truth. May you send the fire of the Holy Spirit upon your people, that we may bear a faithful witness to Christ's resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear us, Lord of glory.
Grant these prayers, O Heavenly Father, for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen.
Amen. We join together in singing hymn number 519, "The Lord's My Shepherd." We will sing verses 1, 2, and 5.
Green.
the prayer over the gifts, which include the gifts that are on the table at the back, as well as offerings that are sent to our office through envelope, e-offering, e-transfer, and online through our parish website. And so let us pray. God of loving care, you spread before us the table of life and give us the cup of salvation to drink. Keep us always in the fold of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Shepherd. Amen. In the collect for today, at the bottom of the page, I invite you to join with me as we pray together. O God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, that great Shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, make us perfect in every good work to do your will, and work in us that which is well-pleasing in your sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us join together in our parish vision statement. We will become a more caring community of believers who learn together, nurture and support each other, and reach out to the community at large with the love of Christ. And may the Lord Jesus, who loves with a wounded heart, be your love forevermore. May the Lord Jesus, who serves with wounded hands, help you serve others. May the Lord Jesus, who walks on wounded feet, walk with you to the end of the road. Look for the face of the Lord Jesus in everyone you meet, and may everyone you meet see the face of Christ in you. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you and all those for whom you pray this day and forevermore. Amen. We join together in singing our recessional hymn, our closing hymn, number 444, Your Hand, O God, Has Guided, and we will sing verses 1 and 5. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.